Hey everyone, so in the last video we rendered out an animation from Eevee and we exported it as an MP4. In this video we're going to export a series of PNGs out inside of Cycles. And you might say, why would I want to do this? Right now I'm going to go ahead into shading and I'm just going to increase the strength of the illumination on both of these. And you'll already see that there are real-time lighting effects that are going on right now. They would be a little bit more challenging to catch inside of Eevee. So I want to be able to export this and get all of these lighting details. I'm going to say from the get-go, this is going to take more time. So let's plan out exactly what we're going to do. First off, I'm going to go to my output settings. And I'm going to go to the same example folder that I was in before. Great. This is where all of my PNGs are going to be added. It's important that I designate a folder as opposed to letting this go to the temporary folder or letting this go onto a desktop or something like that. Next, I'm going to go over, change this to PNG. Great. This is looking pretty good. Now, I want to go over to my render properties and I want to decide the amount of samples that I am going to use per frame, per pixel, actually. So first off, I can get a sense of what this is going to look like by changing my viewport render settings. In this case, I am going to change it to 50 samples. Maybe I even change it to 10 samples. Let's see what that looks like. It's looking okay. Like I said, the lower the sample rate, the less quality that you're going to have, and simultaneously, you are going to have to deal with a little bit of a flickering effect. Because this is for an example, I'm not going to go to an extremely complex amount of samples. I'm just gonna go for something like 7. And denoising, you'll see, is already checked. That means that it's taking away a lot of this noise that is being used to help us simulate these photons over here and to get this these ray paths. So I've designated the amount of samples that I want. I've designated my output settings. In your case, you probably won't have a computer that has an extremely intense GPU. Mine does, so I will end up using it. If you do have a good computer that has a good GPU, go ahead and use that. Right now, I am going to go over to render, and I'm going to go render animation. You'll already start to see that this is taking quite a long time. I'm going to go into my desktop right now, and I'm going to open my examples folder, and I'm just going to see what's happening right here. Great, now that I've gone ahead and exported all of the frames from my animation, I want to bring these back into Blender and reassemble them so that I can export them as an actual movie. Now, I could do this in a variety of different apps. Blender has a pretty good timeline for this. Let's go over there and check this out. First off, I'm just going to delete this guy so that I have this whole folder where all of the images are accessible to me and nothing's getting in the way. So, great, I'm gonna go back into animation now. And instead of going to the dope sheet or the timeline, I am going to be going to the video sequencer. Great. Now, I'm going to go to add, and I'm going to go to image sequence, and I'm going to navigate to my folder. So in this case, my example folder. And let's change this based on the name. So I'm starting at 001 and I'm going to 0060. I'm going to add this image strip. And now that I have this image strip inside of here, I'm actually going to change how I'm going to output this. I'm not going to output this as a PNG, but rather I'm going to output this as an FFmpeg video. I don't want to do Matroska. I want to do MPEG4. And let's just see what this looks like now. Okay, now, really, really quick, really fast, right? Because all it's doing right now is patching those images together as opposed to actually generating them. So this is really useful for me. And if I go into my example folder, you'll see that I now have an animation of these cycles clips. And I bet you're saying to yourself, Duncan, why would you do this? Why not just export it as a video every time? Well, especially with cycles where we have a large amount of time that it's going to take to render this and a lot of very oftentimes there's a lot of errors that end up taking place here. I can restart my animation at any point. If Blender quits for any reason, that's fine. I can just restart the animation at a different entry point. In fact, if I go back into Blender, say for instance, my animation, or Blender quit right at 26 frames, right? I could just start exporting PNGs from 26. And then we go directly into the folder, the sequence would still be exactly the same. If you have any questions on this, let me know. Later on, we can start to do some compositing techniques that are going to essentially be After Effects on top of these images, whether we're influencing saturation or, you know, blur or bloom. There's a variety of different ways that we can manipulate the image after the fact. So I hope you found this useful, and I will see you on Wednesday.